Okay, I want to talk to you all about interpersonal skills. Do you all know what interpersonal skills are?
Interpersonal.
Interpersonal skills.
Your own personal skills?
What are you looking at, red light?
Kinda, sorta.
Like tennis balls.
Kinda, sorta. Your interpersonal skills are sort of like, how do you communicate with other people? How do you respond to certain things when you are maybe on the job or even at home? So, what we're gonna do is talk about those. Now, when you're on the job, the biggest interpersonal skill is communication and how you communicate with those on the job, right? So, what if I was coming to this room and I came in and I was completely the opposite of what I am now? What type of response would I be getting? Okay, it would be negative. It would be a negative response because of the way I communicate with you all. Okay, because of the my interpersonal skills, it would have been real low. You know, I came in, I didn't speak, didn't introduce myself. I just immediately started going into the workshop. And how she looks now is probably how y'all been looking like. Why is she here? Who is this lady? And all of it.
Can she speak?
Yeah, can she speak to me? You know, those are your interpersonal skills. So remember, when you get on a job and you walk through the door, what's the first thing you need to do?
Speak.
Hey, how are you? How are you? Regardless if they speak back or not, you are supposed to what? All right. How do you effective communication? If somebody is saying something you don't understand what they're saying, how do you effectively, or how can you effectively get around it? I quite didn't understand what you were saying. Can you say that over again? It's the sound of what you're talking about and keep walking away. You know, there are ways to effectively communicate within the workplace without offending people and without being offensive, okay? That's the most important thing. Another thing on your interpersonal skills is when you get to work, being productive while you're working. That means you're doing what? Doing what you're supposed to do and actually working.
And doing the right thing.
Right, and trying to, on your first opportunity, getting it correct. So you want to be productive while you are at work, all right? You don't want to be kind of doing nothing and pretending like you're working. I see people pretend as if they are working. You know, they get in the corner and shuffle a couple of boxes around, and then they ain't working. They just shuffling those boxes around. All right? So, you need to make sure that when you get on the job, you're actually doing what you're supposed to do. And if you are not for sure what you are supposed to be doing, you do what? Ask questions.
That's
ask questions, because it's called effective what? Communication. You got to ask questions. Don't sit there and out of space, and they know you're supposed to be working, and you know you're supposed to be working, and you're like, well, I'm scared to ask questions. Don't be afraid to ask questions. Yes, sir.
In that scenario, the worst thing you can do is go back to, like, if you don't understand what they're saying and you sit there and pretend like you're doing, you go over there and mess up, and then you're going to be in bigger trouble.
Right. Yeah. So, And it's more work.
Right.
Right, more work you gotta do.
So it's very important that you ask questions on the front end rather than the back.
Did you get my turn?
Another interpersonal deal that we need to discuss, and I think we kind of hit on it.
I put them back at the table. I don't know if someone
took them. You know, there, I
put them on the table.
You know.
I put them in the drawer.
You know how you were talking, you know, with the hair, like, office, the doctor, and it's always something going on. He said,
yes, I put them back on the table when I finished.
They said, he said, she said.
And it wasn't none in there. It was only two in there when I had to get one.
How to not be. And
I put them in there before, and so when I went in there to check this morning to get one, it was only two left.
All right. How do you not do this? But you know what? Look to me. Say, you don't necessarily have to say that to yourself done right to do away with office gossip. If you don't engage with it, they'll walk away and leave. Take an instant. You and him were talking. And you come up and think about, damn girl, because this is and I can change the subject or say, excuse me, I'm going somewhere else. That's how you can do away with a lot of office gossip and pettiness at the workplace. Don't engage you. That's how a lot of stuff gets started. A lot of people get fired and things that they're not doing. Okay? Mm-hmm. Yes. Always remember, when you go on a job, work, communicate effectively, stay out of office, gossip, and don't engage in it. All right. Also, be a team player in a personal field. Be a team player. If you know y'all getting off at 4 o'clock and you see, you finish your stuff, and you see her over here struggling to finish, don't just sit there and tell me I'm finished. Right. Jump in. You said in the interview you was a team player, right? This is your opportunity to show that you a team player. Jump in. Without someone having to ask you to jump in. Yes, Harold. I know Harold's name. Yes,
so
Harold.
So what if you're with a coworker and they always see what they're taking? You always jump in and help them?
Well, let's take this. Well, first of all, I'm going to talk to you from a management perspective. Okay. Her asked the question was, if you have a coworker who always slow at their job, do you always jump in to assist?
No, they know what they're doing.
What do you mean they know what
they're doing? They know they're doing it. They're doing it on purpose.
You think they're doing it on purpose?
Yup.
So if my first day on the job, and I'm kind of moving slow because I'm trying to get... You think I'm doing it on purpose?
No,
I don't mean you. I mean, some people be doing it.
Some people do it on purpose.
Yes.
So you wouldn't jump in and help.
I would, but then I'll tell them, can you just pick up your pace a little bit?
So would you say it really like this?
No.
But what I would do, let's think of scenarios. The person is always slow in doing his or her job. First question you need to ask, you know, do you need some assistance? Do you need some help? Then, do you understand what's going on? Do you know, is it a problem? Is it something, you know, you may not understand?
You must don't like doing this.
I ain't saying SMU. Did y'all hear me ask the person, you must not like doing it?
Yeah.
No, you ask them, maybe it's something that you may not understand. And what if they say yes? Bam, that's where the problem is. Instead of asking them, you must not like doing it. What was the first interpersonal skill we talked about? Effective what?
Communication.
No, communication.
you keep saying effective, and that makes me say creative.
Constructive criticism, effective communication. So what we have to do is see if he or she actually know what they're, they may be having problems doing the job. It may be something they may not understand. And that is the reason why they're kind of slow about doing the job. And if that's the case, then you may want to tell them, supervisor, that you really quite not understand what's going on, and maybe that will help.
So would it be?
Don't always assume that a person is trying to get old.
So what if I just came, just shotgun all through there and went straight to the mouth and told the mouth? That's what I mean.
No, they don't make him no snitch. They don't make him snitch. Well, I guess I would handle it. Everybody is an individual. I would handle it differently. Okay? And I would actually go to the person, because I'm a real compassionate person, and I want to know what's going on. I'm going to say, you've been kind of behind. Is it something that you don't understand? And if she said yes, have you talked to boss lady about what's going on that you may not understand? If he or she says no, you say, why not? Let's try to encourage them, instead of saying, going straight to boss lady's time. And you ain't going to say it right. I already know this. You would not be using effective communication. You're going to be saying, look here, she messing up because she don't know what she doing. That's what you're going to say.
Mm-hmm. Some people, I think in that scenario where people don't really get what they're doing, it's because some people don't have routine. Like, when you learn stuff for the first time, if you don't have routine, you'll be slow. But once you get yourself in a routine, you're going to learn how to do it, and you're going to be so slow. But everybody, some people are visual, some people are, some people like to be hands-on. So sometimes it's about having a routine.
Right. And sometimes it's about not having a routine, being taught.
Mm-hmm.
Very good. Do y'all have any questions thus far? No questions? Y'all have been such a great group. They really have. They've been one of my most engaging groups. I really enjoyed this group.
We're great.
I really did. Now, I'm about to hand out. Y'all got some pens?
She's supposed to be going to get some.
Okay. I'm going to hand out some evaluation. I want you to evaluate how well I did with the workshop, okay? So you're going to be evaluating me.
We evaluate you?
Yeah, you okay. Evaluate me.
You did great.
I want you to be completely honest, because this helps me when I prepare for my workshop. And I'm going to go over it with you, okay? It's not going to take long. I promise. I did graduate from Tupelo. I'm going to go over with you guys.
What was your major?
I got my first degree. I have an undergraduate in psychology from Tupelo.
So you read everybody here from walking it down.
No, I wasn't.
No, I was talking to
somebody.
No. You
talk about doctor? No, I'm not
talking about doctor. So if I get sick right now, I can talk to you.
I'm not a medical doctor.
So you can't sit there.
No, I'm not a psychologist. I'm a social worker.
There. Well, I'm well here. You got one of the cats.